Well, well, well. Here we are again, gentlemen. I have some questions, and I'm going to give you some answers. Let's see. This one here was given to me some, I guess, female activist or some bullshit. Basically wants to know abortion and what's my take on it. To be honest with you, I'm an older gentleman, and, you know, now that I have children, I kind of think abortion is the selfish thing. But with that being said, I don't think that the taxpayer needs to pay for that bullshit. They can do that on their own if they want to, you know, do what they got to do. I would say I am probably more of a pro-life guy. You know, I got two kids. One more probably wouldn't have killed me, but it is what it is. I'm beyond that now, so let's move on. Next one I got was, what is my take on physical violence against women? Well, my take is simply this, is you really don't do physical violence to anybody. And if somebody does physical violence to you, then you defend yourself accordingly. Because guess what, ladies? The feminists out there have you signed up to fight as an infantry guy. So guess what? You wanted to fight, and now you're gonna get it. You should have shut your goddamn mouth or got in those feminist ass and say, hey, we have a good thing here. We don't have to sign up for the draft. We get all this shit for free. What the hell's wrong with you? So, you know, if a woman wants to step up and take a swing, then you take your chances. It is what it is. Very unhappy with the single mother video. Like, I don't give a shit. I made it to tell the truth. Granted, it doesn't hit everyone the same, but it is what it is. Single mothers have been growing astronomically over the past 20, 30 years. They take more from the system that they put in, and then the children that they raise, 80% of them wind up in prison or the funny farm or dead from an OD or, I don't know, suicide. So all in all, if you decide to bring children into this world and you decide that, hey, the father doesn't have to be around, well, 18 to 21 years later, I have only one thing to say to you. I hope the check was worth it, bitch. I get this one asked all the time, and they're like, have you ever killed anybody? Well, you know, if you stand in line long enough, you're going to get what you're waiting for. So that's what one of my old platoon sergeants told me years ago. And this is how I answer that question, and it's kind of like a poem. It goes, directly, indirectly, partially, or in whole, I've dealt enough death to doom my soul. And I take no pleasure, and there certainly isn't any pride. It's the rules of the world in which I abide. That pretty much covers everything. I have enough shit bumping around here to keep my nightmares freshly stocked for the next three lifetimes. What is the secret to happiness? Like, what the fuck do you think I am? I'm the Dalai Lama or something? Bottom line is, you're responsible for your own goddamn happiness. Nobody sent you here to juggle cats and chainsaws so you can make other people happy. You do what you need to do to make yourself happy, because no one else is going to do it. And if you gentlemen are in those bad marriages, and you're sacrificing your hopes, your dreams, and your future to keep this woman happy, you probably need to sit down and have a great discussion with yourself on the cost-benefit analysis of this whole bullshit. Because chances are, it's not worth it. Women are expensive to divorce, but in the end, that is worth it. Why did I do the PTSD video? They want to know why I did it, and I'm not a therapist, and it's none of my business. Well, I've been dealing with PTSD since roughly 1989. I've had quite a few run-ins. I know exactly how it works. You get the anxiety, the hypervigilance, problem with focusing and attention, the whole deal. And if somebody who's actually exposed to that shit and tells you how to deal with it or what exactly is happening, how does somebody who learned about it in a college through a book have the guts to say that shit to me? Most of the therapists out there, they got their experience from reading a book, watching videos, maybe they talked to a few guys. Listen, if you got PTSD and it's from combat, you need to talk to a combat vet who's qualified to walk you through the whole goddamn thing. And don't put much stock in the academia, because more often than not, they're nothing but a bunch of idiots. Why do men stop seeing their kids? Okay, well, I can't answer that in total, but you can check out Deadbeat Dad Dilemma. That's the financial reasons, because they get so much money taken from him, and it's like a dog chasing his tail. He just doesn't get anywhere. And another thing I've noticed, that men are really good at building shit, right? And especially walls. And a lot of men get raked through the coals in divorce court. They're called every name in the book. They're pieces of shit. They get out, they do their deal, and they set up a wall. And everything on the other side of the wall no longer exists, and they move on from there. And a lot of times, unfortunately, the kids are on the wrong side of the wall. So those women out there who bitch and complain that the father of the kid never comes around, guess what? When you're pointing the finger at him, there's three fingers pointing back at you, because you let the system destroy him, and this is the only way he can survive. So fuck off, single mothers and divorced women. Sorry. What is my take on the Berkeley riots? All right. First of all, Milo Yiannopoulos, he's a provocateur. He talks a bunch of shit. He's kind of like me, except I'm not gay. He tells it how it is. And people are having a hard time hearing the truth, because apparently they've been spoken to for so long with political correctness that the sharpness, the edge of the truth no longer hurts. So when you tell them the truth and it hurts, you're getting labeled as some kind of white supremacist, hate speech, what have you. To be honest with you, I don't mind if they protest, that's just fine. But when they start destroying shit, all I can say is, if I was a storekeeper in that area, I would stay at my store with a 12-gauge shotgun. I'd have rock salt and buckshot mixed in between. If somebody kicked down the door and came to the shop, I'd hit him with a rock salt. If they didn't leave, I'd smoke them with the buckshot. That's what it is. And I guarantee you, if more people did that, there wouldn't be all this goddamn rioting, because things get real polite when people are throwing lead at each other. So that's just what I have to say. But I appreciate all your feedback. And if you want me to answer any of your questions or touch on any subjects, just let me know. You know, I'm up all night anyway. Might as well do something productive. But you keep driving on and doing what you got to do. You have a nice day.